If 1, 2 is a point on the graph of f of x, which ordered pair must also be on the graph of y equals f of the quantity x minus 2 minus 3? So here's the given point 1, 2, where x equals 1 and y equals 2. And again, this is a point on our function f of x, therefore we can say that f of 1 equals positive 2. We want to find a point that would be on y equals f of the quantity x minus 2 minus 3. There are a couple ways to determine what point must be on this new function. One way would be to recognize the translations based upon this function notation. So for a review, if we begin with a function f of x, where both c and d are positive, y equals f of x plus d would shift the graph up d units, since the function values here are y values. So if we add d to the y values, it would shift the graph up. Versus here, if we have y equals f of x minus d, we're now subtracting d from the function values or y values, which would shift the graph down d units. Next we have y equals f of the quantity x plus c. Notice how this plus c is going to affect the inputs into our function, and because we're adding c to x, we'd actually have to use smaller values of x to produce the same inputs as the basic function f of x, which means by adding c here, it would actually shift the graph left c units because we'd be using smaller values of x to produce the same inputs as f of x. And then finally we have y equals f of the quantity x minus c. Notice here we're subtracting c from x, and therefore we have to use larger values of x to produce the same inputs as the basic function f of x. So because we're using larger values of x, it would shift the graph right c units. So going back to our example, using translations, f of the quantity x minus 2 would shift the graph of f of x, or in this case the point, 2 units to the right, because we'd have to use an x value 2 units larger to get the same input. And then this minus 3 on the end here takes these function values or y values and subtracts 3, which means it would then shift the point down 3 units. Which means the point 3, comma negative 1 must be on y equals f of the quantity x minus 2 minus 3. To make sure that we really understand this, let's look at this another way. Let's say we wanted the input of this function to be positive 1 so that we knew the output would be positive 2. If we want this input to be positive 1, notice how x would have to be equal to 3. Because if we have y equals f of the quantity 3 minus 2 and then minus 3, notice how 3 minus 2 is 1. So this would give us y equals f of 1 minus 3. But notice how by setting x equal to 3, it shifted the point 2 units to the right. And then finally, since we know f of 1 equals 2, we can say y equals 2 minus 3, which means y equals negative 1. So by subtracting 3 from these function values, it actually shifted the graph down 3 units, giving us the y-coordinate of negative 1. So whichever way we look at it, this point, 3, comma, negative 1, must be on the function y equals f of the quantity x minus 2 minus 3.